Before we move into writing the code for Pitch Perfect, I want to cover a software pattern that will be really useful in your time as an iOS developer. Let me introduce the Mvc pattern to you. We're going to build a Pitch Perfect app using this pattern, so knowing it will be really handy to figure out where we are and where we need to be. The Model View Controller pattern hails back from the Mac development days of the 80s. It is still as useful today as it was then. You'll see it called Model View Controller, or MVC for short. We can think of our Pitch Perfect app as having three parts. The view, which the user sees with the buttons, the model, which is where we store the recorded audio file, and the controller, which we use to store and retrieve data from the model and show it in the view. Think of the data your app contains. For Pitch Perfect, this is just an audio file. But as you progress as an iOS developer, you will build ever more complicated apps, which you need to store a lot more data. All of the classes involved with storing and maintaining this data can be referred to as the model. On the other side of the diagram, we have the view. The view is what the user sees on screen and how they interact with the app. The view does not know anything about the data itself, or the model, as we call it here. It only knows how to display the subset of data that it's given. It is just your user interface. In between them, and in charge of providing the view with data and the model with any actions from the view, is the controller. When a user action happens on the view, the controller is notified. If needed, it updates the model. When the model is changed by some external event, it notifies the controller, which can update the view if needed. Maybe you're thinking, why not just embed all of the model data code inside the view? Well, it's often the case that you need to have multiple different views to show some parts of the same data. What would you do then? Copy and pasting the code would quickly turn this project into what one of my colleagues refers to as copy pasta. Great to eat, but horrible to have in your code. Having a division in responsibility between the model, the view, and the controller in between makes your code easy to maintain, easy to understand, and reusable. As we start building Pitch Perfect together, you're going to see the model, the view, and the controller parts and how they communicate. Students have found it really handy to have this pattern and thought in the back of their minds as they're developing for iOS. It helps to keep their apps structured and easier to develop.